name is Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to collect the mass and volume information that we need to determine the density of our sugar water solutions. The first thing that we are going to do is collect our equipment. We're going to need a 10 milliliter graduated cylinder. We're also going to need a scale, volume, mass. And to transfer things successfully without spilling, we'll need a pipette. We can either use a disposable Pasteur pipette with pipette bulb, and it would look like this, or we can use a disposable plastic pipette. I prefer the Pasteur pipette for the experiments today. Next, we're going to bring in our materials. We're going to use some water first, and then we're going to use our four solutions. For each experiment, we're going to perform the same exact process. So I will demonstrate on the first, and then you will repeat all the others the same exact way. The first thing that we need to record for density is going to be mass. To record the mass, we're going to turn on our scale. When it shows 0.00, we will place our graduated cylinder on top. We're going to tear, and then we're going to transfer a small amount of water into the graduated cylinder. Because we teared it, it means that whatever we add to it is going to be just the mass of the water. For our first measurement, let's aim for a volume anywhere between 3 and 5 milliliters. So we record first the mass. For me, it is 3.06 grams. And then we lower ourselves down to eye level and record the volume of the same amount of water. And for me, that will be 3.08 milliliters. Next, we're going to add more water. This time we're going to aim for anywhere between 5 and 7 milliliters. My scale now says 6.11 grams, and this includes the water from the first edition and the second edition. And then I will record my volume again. I will lower myself to eye level and record the volume that is now 6.10 milliliters. And for the third measurement, we're going to add more water. And this time we're going to aim anywhere between 9 and 10 milliliters because our graduated cylinder does not allow us to read a volume beyond 10. The mass now is 9.15 grams and the volume is 9.12 milliliters. From the three recorded masses and the three recorded volumes, we will have our density. The three numbers should be relatively close together because density is an intensive property and it should not matter how much water we have, only that it is the same water that we're using in the same measurement. Now that we are done with the water, we can discard it and move on to our next solution. And that will be our blue solution. To move on to the next experiment, what we need to do is clear completely our graduated cylinder, and this will include both the washing of the graduated cylinder and the drying of the graduated cylinder. I will not dispose of this solution now that I collected all my mass and volume measurements. Instead, I'm going to pour it back to my original container for the final part of the experiment. For the next part, you will do the same type of three recorded measurements for mass and volume for your green solution, your yellow solution, and the red one. Keeping in mind that in between measurements, in between solutions, you will need to rinse and completely dry your graduated cylinder and thoroughly rinse your pipette. Thank you.